University of Oregon's registration pages have gotten a makeover. There are a few items, though, that are still the same. Let's go over those first. The first one is how to check if you have a hold. Start by logging into duckweb.uoregon.edu with your 95 number and PAC. Select Student Menu. Select View Holds. Review for any holds that have the hold annotation of registration. For more information on how to interpret the information on the screen, watch the Help with Holds video. Now let's talk about the second thing that's still the same, how to know your registration time. Similarly, log into duckweb.uoregon.edu with your 95 number and PAC. Select Student Menu. Then select Registration Menu. Select Check Registration Eligibility. Then select a term using the drop-down and click the Submit button. In the You may register during the following times area, the table will include the date and the time that you can first register for the selected term. Now, let's review the portion of registration pages that received a makeover. I will share a brief description of each one and why and when you can use it. How to get there. Start by logging into duckweb.uoregon.edu with your 95 number and PAC. Select Student Menu. Select Registration Menu. Then select Registration Dashboard. This takes you to the new Registration Landing page. On this page, there is a What Would You Like to Do area with multiple actions that you can take. Let's go through them. The first one, prepare for registration. At this time, this page contains minimal information that is useful. You may have holds listed here, but not all holds may be listed here. Refer to Student Menu, View Holds for complete hold information. What is useful on this page? If you have been authorized for an override to register for a course, for example, taking a course without a required major or prerequisite, the specifics will be shared under the header Permit Override. My screen shares that I have been given overrides to register for CRN 25356, Writing 121Z, and it lists the type of overrides that were given to me. I return to the registration landing page by clicking the registration breadcrumb. In the What Would You Like to Do area, the next item is Plan Ahead. This is where I can create potential plans prior to my registration time. Students can also use their plans to register when their initial registration time arrives. The next item in the What Would You Like to Do area is View Registration Information. The View Registration Information shares information on courses that are not yet graded when a term is selected. This is a great tool for confirming changes like grade mode or variable credit changes or withdrawing from courses. The next item in the What Would You Like to Do area that I want to draw attention to is the Browse Classes. This is very similar to the Search for Classes that was previously available, in that it allows you to search and receive results with information like CRN, class meeting days and times, instructors, and instructional method, like in person or online, for each class. The final item in the What Would You Like to Do area is Register for Classes. This is where you make active registration changes. For example, it's currently fall 25, and registration for winter 2026 is not yet open. Therefore, I can only make changes to my fall 25 registration in the Register for Classes area at this time. Once my initial registration time arrives for winter 26, I will be able to also make changes to add, to drop, or to adjust courses for my winter 2026 registration. Thank you for joining me for a quick review of the new registration landing page. We will continue to update our webpage, registrar.uoregon.edu, and these videos when changes are made.